The something was a pocketbook full of poems. Paul had put some of his beautiful fancies into verse, and magazine editors had not been as unappreciative as they are sometimes supposed to be. Anne read Paul's poems with real delight. They were full of charm and promise. "You'll be famous yet, Paul. I always dreamed of having one famous pupil. He was to be a college president, but a great poet would be even better. Some day I'll be able to boast that I whipped the distinguished Paul Irving. But then I never did whip you, did I, Paul? What an opportunity lost. I think I kept you in at recess, however. You may be famous yourself, teacher. I've seen a good deal of your work these last 3 years. No, I know what I can do. I can write pretty, fanciful little sketches that children love and editors send welcome checks for. But I can do nothing big. My only chance for earthly immortality is a corner in your memoirs." Carlotta the Fourth had discarded the blue bows, but her freckles were not noticeably less. "I never did think I'd come down to marrying a Yankee, Miss Shirley, ma'am," she said. "But you never know what's before you, and it isn't his fault. He was born that way." "You're a Yankee yourself, Carlotta, since you've married one." "Miss Shirley, ma'am, I'm not. And I wouldn't be if I was to marry a dozen Yankees. Tom's kind of nice. And besides, I thought I'd better not be too hard to please, for I mightn't get another chance. Tom don't drink, and he don't growl because he has to work between meals, and when all's said and done, I'm satisfied, Miss Shirley, ma'am." "Does he call you Leonora?" asked Anne. "Goodness, no, Miss Shirley, ma'am. I wouldn't know who he meant if he did. Of course, when we got married, he had to say, 'I take thee, Leonora,' and I declare to you, Miss Shirley, ma'am, I've had the most dreadful feeling ever since that it wasn't me he was talking to, and I haven't been rightly married at all." "And so you're going to be married yourself, Miss Shirley, ma'am? I always thought I'd like to marry a doctor. It would be so handy when the children had measles and croup. Tom is only a bricklayer, but he's real good-tempered. When I said to him, says I, 'Tom, can I go to Miss Shirley's wedding? I mean to go anyhow, but I'd like to have your consent.' He just says, 'Suit yourself, Carlotta, and you'll suit me.' That's a real pleasant kind of husband to have, Miss Shirley, ma'am.